Hey guys, what up guys, it's Musical Leaders here today and I'm back with another video. Now today's video we'll be reacting to NF's song called Trust featuring Tech N9ne. This song was recommended to me by a subscriber of mine named Alan Scott. He said go check it out. I said 100% I'll definitely do it. So big thank you to Alan Scott for the suggestion. Like I said, I like doing a voice play, you know, reaction videos, but I felt like I was just doing them solely and I wanted to venture off and do other, you know, songs and stuff. And I love listening to other music, especially rock music. And I still do love rap music. It's just certain types of rap music I really enjoy. And NF is an artist that I have listened to before. I do like his style. I think that, you know, his music is very, you know, heartfelt. It's very personal to him. And I really respect that because his music actually has meaning. It's not just him, you know, just rapping or him just bragging or whatever. It's just him actually explaining his life and, you know, his struggles and stuff. So I really respect that and admire that. Also, Tech N9ne is just a legend in, you know, the rap industry. He's made so many songs and stuff, and, you know, his style is always weird and crazy, and I like that about him. So, yeah, I'm going to really enjoy this. I've never heard this song. I have heard quite a bit of Tech N9ne songs and NF songs, but I just never heard this one. So, yeah, let's get into it. So he's starting off with a fast rap. It says the music video. I guess this was in the official one. I don't think they might have a music video, to be honest, from what I looked up. So yeah, I know that it isn't because it had a bunch of mashup from his other songs that I heard and it's just, you know, not coherent. But his fast rapping flow, a lot of people have now really disliked it because of, you know, Eminem doing it. And then a lot of people saying that, oh, this fast rapping flow is just for rappers who can't rap, you can do it fast, but don't know how to rap and don't have any meaningful lyrics. So to cover that up and that the lack of talent that they use their speed to, you know, cover that up and to showcase that off. But for me personally, I can definitely see that. But the problem with that argument is those people that say that just leave it at that and they don't look at the lyrics of what it says. It's like, okay, if that's the case, then, well, let's see the lyrics and let's see if that is true, which a lot of times is not true. When I see Eminem do it, a lot of times his lyrics still mean something. They have connections. It's just in a faster flow. And that's what I see with him. He's talking about he had multiple different cadences in a song. Basically, this is him showing off that he can do multiple different talents. He can do slow, he can do fast, he can do hard, he can do a more softer one, he can do more introspective, he can do just pure lyrical songs. So he's just trying to show off his skill, but like, I feel a lot of rappers that do fast rapping do get a lot of trash for it because they're like, oh, they're just rapping fast. But it's like, here's the thing. Those people that say the same shit about them are the ones that also listen to people who mumble and make the same repetitive ass songs and make gimmicky songs that is just like basic bullshit. And they praise that, but then they hate on artists like this who just do this once in a while, like, you know, fast raps. But like I said, they don't even look deep into the lyrics. They just say, well, they're fast and rap, and they're not saying, not saying anything in it. And then you look at the lyrics, and they actually have meanings, because he was making sense in what he was saying. He was telling the story, his progression through his career, what he can do, what he's at, where he's at. He's explaining something, and people don't want to listen. They just hear the fast part, and they're like, oh my god, really, another fast rap? It's like, well, I don't want to hear another slurred rap or a guy mumbling like a motherfucker, like, you know, a disabled dude. Like, I want to hear somebody that I can understand what they're saying. So I really don't like that. I also do see a lot of racism when it comes to the white artists. They always just label them as an Eminem copy like they do with him, which I don't like that. personally, yes, Eminem, he has a lot of styles, like, it's similar to Eminem, but I don't want to compare him to him because he's his own artist. I don't think it's fair to, you know, subjugate him to just, you know, one artist because that one artist is the biggest thing in his, you know, race or whatever. That's just stupid. So, yeah, but definitely big respect to him. He has a lot of lyrical talent. And if you listen to his other songs, you know, he has so much depth to his music. And the reason why I really appreciate and respect his music compared to other rappers is he's actually talking about his personal life. And it's not the basic, I sold drugs on the corner. Nobody gives a shit about that. You could have died on the corner. We don't care at this point. Like, it's just repetitive. And most of them didn't even do that. For any part of me that wanna make it harder, cause that'll take away the happiness. It could be kinda pathetic, but when I look at everything, it's trying to give me a headache. You gotta be honest, I've really been the cause of it. Get it? Cause I can see inside of me, you never see. You can tell when I'm at the breaking point. I finally had to sit with the devil. I'm winning the hell in the ass. So with the problem is yelling, he's trying to get me to look at them. Make me call me a sinner and tell me everything about me. Doesn't feel like a winner. So I continue when he's telling me I might as well give up. I took a moment, thought about it, feeling caught in the middle. But got offended when he told me I would live in the kennel. When I can never leave it, even if I made it to heaven, he found a way to give me back. He sent a demon to give me a life. Skin and bones, be my ego. How's he look? He don't eat much, let him starve. I don't feed him, I just beat him. I just leave him in his room, in a fetal. Let him cry, let him yell, let him scream. I don't need him. I latch on to like a pit dog. I sit calm with a sick thought of a sitcom with a life I live. Life I live more like a sci-fi flick. I hide it, wanna watch that right in. My silence doesn't mean I'm dying, just means I'm careful with the time I spend. So look what I die. Hey, helping the people I love. I love. My life is not what it was. No, I do whatever I must. Kind of one hand who I trust. 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 Lean up, next king up. Everyone knowing that I'm a death bringer. The thing I like about Tech N9ne, you can see that he always has some unique style to it. Like, in, I forgot what song, it was in Speed'em with, you know, Twista and Eminem. He had the one where he was saying all these, like, he was rapping fast and he was putting all these, words that had the V, with, like, a V in it. And he was just trying to do that. And in this one, he's doing, he's stretching out the end. I don't know what they call it because I'm not an expert when it comes to music stuff. I know some people say my name, like, musically, just it's just to be, you know, it's more of a joking type of name. It's not literally. I'm not some music savant. I've never even gone to, like, you know, a prestigious music school. But, yeah, when he does the part where he stretches out towards the end, bisting sing he keeps on doing that. He stretches that part out, and it makes his, you know, his flow unique. NF1 is the more fast one, the more harder hitting one, the more, you know, trying to combine a bunch of stuff. Like, he had the whole flow about the devil and locking him up. I think when he was talking about starving and stuff and beating him up, I think he was talking about the devil. It could also have been a, you know, metaphor for, you know, other rappers and, you know, how he deals with them and stuff. But Tech N9ne's one, he comes in with his own unique flow where he does that a lot when he, like, stretches out the last part of his, you know, his verse and stuff. He always says that and stuff. So yeah, I really do like when he does that. That part was amazing. I love when, you know, artists switch a flow to a certain way. They go into, like, a little fast or, like, you know, a little unique pocket of theirs where they change the flow and then they go transitioning back to the original song. Like, he was going to, like, he started off with the parts and then he went to the, you know, fast rapping. Then he did that one where he was, like, combining stuff. It did remind me once again of Speed'em when he did with, like, the V words, and that was, like, the climax. Like, it was, like, the song felt like it was reaching up a climax with it. So I like that part. I really love his, you know, way of rapping, his, you know, his different styles that he has. He has, like, you know, a style that he sticks to a lot of times, but they're really unique and fun the way he does it. I'm closing it up.
gonna eat like a hungry orifice. T9 and NFL elephants in the room without a closet for skeletons. Quit embellishing. A demon from hell is a yelling with none of y'all.
So that was Trust by NF at featuring Tech N9ne. Thank you once again to Alan Scott for the suggestion. I really enjoy that song, but before I get into it, I do want to say that the audio is going to sound a little bit different on this video. Usually I do a screen recording and a separate audio recording on top of it. And when it comes to the music part, I'm quiet. So, you know, I don't want to like talk in the middle of it because I usually cut out my own voice while the song's playing. And then once when it transitions to me talking and pausing it, then I cut out the audio for, you know, the music stuff. But after I just finished it up, which I usually wrap it up and, you know, edit to get to the ending, what happened was apparently the file didn't save for the audio. Usually what I used to do is just get it off of the back of my computer. Some people complained because the audio didn't sound too well and I wanted to make it better. Sadly, it didn't take the file and audio, so sorry for that. I don't know what happened to it, but I don't want to react to it again, you know, and pretend like, you know, it was my first time. So yeah, if the audio doesn't sound as good, once again, I'm sorry. Whatever happened to the thing, the audio recording itself fucked up. I just retested right now and it worked, which is annoying because it worked for something that I didn't need, but when I needed it, it didn't work, but whatever. Going back to the, you know, the song, the reason why I didn't talk about a lot of the lyrics and stuff is the fact that it was a lot of fast rapping, and I felt like the more importance was the cadence of the rap and the meaning behind it, and I can get the gist of the meaning behind it. With NF, is, you know, him fighting and his hunger and what he has to deal with and where he's coming up from. And, you know, it's just basically one of those songs about, like, oh, the struggle type of song where, like, what struggles he's going through as an artist or to become, like, you know, a big artist. And then Tech N9ne, his part, I really loved. He's always great with the fast rap, but he's also great with his bars. And his flow in this song was very, very fun. I really liked how unique it got. He was messing with the style of it very much. He started off, like, you know, just stretching outwards towards the in the ending. And then he went to fast rapping, and then he went to a little pocket flow where he was just, you know, destroying it. Then went back to the fast rap and then switched it up again. So I really appreciate that about, you know, Tech N9ne. And if I'm being honest, I think Tech N9ne had my favorite part in this song, but NF's part was really hype. Once when it's transitioned back to NF's part, it's like the energy level, or, you know, changed up again, but it was like, you know, a fun energy level. When you saw him in the, when I saw him in the crowd, you know, bouncing up and down with all those other, you know, fans and stuff, it fit perfectly well with the song itself, because the song had like kind of a feeling of like, you know, a jumping up and down type of feeling. So, you know, seeing that was pretty cool. So yeah, once again, I'm sorry for the audio that it wasn't perfect. I try to make it work. I do not know why the hell the thing just messed up out of nowhere. It was just so stupid. So yeah, but the audio is not going to sound as great, but at least you can still hear it. And the whole point of these videos is to see my reaction to it and what I have to say about it. But yeah, I really enjoy this song. NF is a really great artist. Like I said, I've heard him before. I really respect the guy. I think he deserves a lot more respect and credit than he gets. Tech N9ne is just a legend in all right. So yeah, that's really great. So yeah, if any of you guys have any other suggestions for any other songs from different genres, different topics, different stuff, definitely give it to me, because I want to react to as many different types of songs as possible. Yeah, at this point, I just want my channel to be unique. I don't want to rely on just one group or artist's music. I want to do a bunch of other songs, and I want to stick to more songs that are not cover songs. I want to go on songs that are originally created by some artist, you know, because I want to see more of originally created music instead of just music that somebody else had but is done cover for. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and stay tuned for next time.